It's already 9:30 exactly. Only 10 members they have joined till now. You should be punctual and adhere to the schedule which has been sent to you. Sharp 9:30, most of you must present. CR, are you there?
Yes, sir.
E3, what is your name?
Sana.
Huh?
Sana.
Okay, fine. Sana, when the class will be going on, please take the screenshot. When the students are maximum, they present in the class. Please take the screenshot and you might be having my contact number. Please send it to that contact number. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Fine. Please, daily you can do that same thing. Huh?
Okay, sir.
If you are unfortunately being absent, please let me know. You could inform to other boys here, something like that, so that he will be sending the screenshots. Okay?
Okay, sir.
If you are available, then no issues. Finally. Itin, I'm going to start the subject. While I was taking the introduction class, only few were present, around 8 to 10 students were present in the class. So let me introduce myself. It's in the first time I'm going to handle the subject to you. But TR2 have not taken any class till now. So in the current semester, I'm going to handle the subject microwave engineering for you. And let me introduce, my name is Venkateshwar Rao, and almost I have 18 years of teaching experience, and around 3 to 4 times I have handled this particular subject, microwave engineering, and the subject was somewhat different earlier when I have handled this particular subject. No issues, so the concept, it has been well known, clearly it can be done for you. So if you have any doubts during the session, you can unmute yourself and you can go ahead so that your doubt may be cleared there itself, or you can ping me, or you can give an, a chat message so that I can clear the doubts. And apart from that, I insist you please have a running notes. So whenever I cover the few points in a particular topic, so it may not be available in the material which is being sent to you, so that you can write as in a running notes. Please maintain a separate notes for each and every subject, and so that it will be easier for you. And please have a glance around of, try to spend around 5 to 10 minutes for this particular subject. And after the commencement of all the classes, so that you might be knowing the difficulty of online classes. So parallelly, you should work hard and try to clear the points, whatever discussed in the class on that particular day itself. And if you have any doubts, so that it can be cleared in the next class, so that if you follow the same scenario, then it will be easier for you to understand the concept, the basic concepts, and you will feel the subject has been easier for you. It's been nothing difficult, and it's been very easy subject. And apart from this particular theoretical subject, you too have the laboratory, microwave engineering lab, and me too, one of the person is in charge faculty for that particular lab, and we'll be doing an experiments. Yesterday it might be taken for you. If not, okay, it may not be taken. Okay, we have recorded the experiments as well, and we'll be sharing during the lab session, so that each and every point, how to perform an experiment, is clearly explained to you. And wherever you find a difficulty, it will be explained simultaneously during the lab session, as the experiment is being keep on playing into the class. Okay, right now, I'm going to start with a subject, and I'm going to handle the microwave engineering subject. And let us have just a brief discussion around just 2 to 3 minutes, around 5 minutes, what are all the contents which are present. And I'll be giving what are the textbooks and the reference books which is to be used for this particular subject. And apart from that, I'll be sharing the material. Please, apart from that, please maintain a separate notes for you, so that it will be easier for you to understand the things, and whichever the doubts you have, we can note it down there. And the first unit, it is being totally depends upon the transmission lines, and I am going to discuss what are these transmission lines in detail when we go into the subject. You might be having an idea about the transmission line. It's a type of medium which take the information from source to destination, from one point to another point to get communicated. We'll be making use of these transmission lines. And there are different types of transmission lines which can be used at a lower frequency and a higher frequency. The type of transmission lines used at higher frequency, that is the microwave frequency, it will be different. And we'll see why we can't use these transmission lines at lower frequency, why the other frequency it is being required or designed at microwave frequencies. And we'll see about these microwave frequencies, what are the band, what is the frequency band of these microwave frequencies, and we'll have the classification for the discussion. We'll be doing that. And after that, the rectangular waveguide we have, and this rectangular waveguide is the type of transmission line which is used at microwave frequencies. So please be attentive. If you are not able to follow at any point, you can unmute and you can ask me, and I'll be asking the doubts. So by picking up the rule numbers which is been displaying over here, so that you could able to answer that. And just don't be log in and move out and keep on doing your personal works. Don't do any. Please be attentive. And this is a rectangular waveguide. Is in a first classification. Is a type of transmission line which is used at microwave frequencies. And next we have this microwave upon this rectangular waveguides, we have the strip lines. We'll see what is mean by this strip line and how it is being used. And this all about the first unit, the basic concepts related to the microwaves we are going to discuss in the first unit. And in second case, we have a waveguide components. As I told that you will be having a lab session related to this microwave engineering, where we'll be introducing you and we'll be showing you a video for the microwave components. What are the components which is being used, and how the components will be there, and what are the importance of each and every component over there. We'll be having a brief discussion. The same theoretical concepts or discussion, it will be covered in the second unit. And all these different types of microwave components are discussed in the second unit. Then later on, we have the next case, we have the third unit we have, and the third unit, it has been, as I've told, the microwave sources. We know that there are different types of sources which is used at a lower frequency. That is nothing but the power supply, the voltage source and a current source, which are generating the current and voltages there. Similarly, we have some sources which generates the microwave frequency signals. And for that, we'll be having the microwave, the sources which is generating the microwave frequencies. And that is nothing but microwave tube. So this microwave tube is a type of source which generates the microwave frequencies. And we have a further classification. So this O-type tube is a classification which will be covering in the third unit. So O-type tubes under microwave, under the sources, microwave sources, O-type is one of the classification, and M-type is another classification. This O type, whatever the types and classification, it is nothing but two cavity klystron and a reflex klystron. These two will come under the category of O type tubes, and same can be covered in the third unit. What is the amplification it is being done? What are the construction? What are the principle of operation? What is the waveform? And followed by some equations we have. That entire detailed discussion related to the O type can be covered in third unit. And whereas the other type is of M-type tubes, these M-type tubes will be covered in fourth unit. And we have a magnetron is the main component or the source which is used at microwave frequencies and coming under the category of M-type tubes. It is being covered in fourth unit. And next after that, we have the last unit. So last unit has been easier. And apart from this, we have some easy, the second part has been easy. As I told, we have in a lab. So in that lab, the fifth unit. So this fifth unit is nothing but we have a microwave solid state devices. We have the gun diode and transfer electronic devices is the principle on which the gun diode will be operating. And there are two to three sources or topics which are covered in first half. That is a gun diode and the laser diode and the avalanche transit time diodes. So this is the two to three topics which we are going to discuss. Please unmute yourself, Andy. Who is that? Please maintain some attitude, Andy. If you have any doubts, I'm ready to clear that, but not to disturb the class, Andy. I will try to improve to get a scribbling pad and the slate by writing. I'll be explaining in the next time classes. So as in a basic introduction, I am using the basic things to take the class. And the second part is of microwave measurements. As I told, we are going to perform the experiments in microwave engineering lab regarding some parameters. We have some parameters like frequency measurement, VSWR measurement, impedance measurement, attenuation measurement. So all these measurements which we are going to perform in the microwave laboratory, the same theoretical concept, it is been described in this second half, the fifth unit second half. It has been very easy, and not more than 3 to 4 classes it takes to cover this particular second half part. So already you will be having idea about the microwave lab. So 2 to 3 classes has been more than enough to cover this. And it is easier to attempt. Okay, so you can easily score maximum in the fifth unit. And all the units are similarly done. In the third unit, O-type tubes, one of the tubes will be asking in the examination. In the fourth unit, about one of the tubes of M-type classification will be asked. In the fifth unit, the measurements will be asked. Okay, the microwave components in the second unit and the basic transmission lines in the first unit. So definitely the questions which will be asked are very important. And the topics also very few. In the second unit, we have only third unit, we have only O-type tubes, 2 to 3 O-type tubes. In whatever be the way the question it has been asked, the same, it has been among those 2 to 3 topics only. Okay. So within those 2 to 3 topics, only the questions will be generally asked. We have, we'll be providing the question papers also, the previous question papers. And only the thing that you have to follow up and keep on having a continuation regarding this particular subject. Please keep on touch with this subject. Okay. So and coming to the textbooks, is the LIAO here. So you can note it down, the LIAO, the soft copy, it may also be available. The LIAO is a standard textbook. And one of our professor, who has been there, you might be knowing her, Vandana Khare, ma'am. And she and herself with one of the professor, Dr. N. Sudhakar, sir, they have written a book, which has been available in the library. You can have as a reference, you can check out. Okay, so it has been a somewhat easier language. You can make use of even that textbook for you for this particular subject. And apart from that, you can use one or two reference books as Kulkarni. And it's in a local author. Kulkarni is in a local author, Umesh Publications. You can use as a reference books. So these are all the basic details which we are going to discuss in this particular current semester, the microwave engineering. And I request all of you, I should have a request that please cooperate and support. I need your complete cooperation support regarding this particular subject to cover it successfully, the entire syllabus, and more easier way, in the way you feel it very easy and very standard manner, and without missing enough topic, and equally have to check out to the maximum extent. It has to be analyzed by yourself. To that extent, I want to reach this particular subject to you, and so that I want your complete cooperation to complete this subject successfully. And meanwhile, if you have any doubt at any time, you can ask me. I'm ready to clear up that doubts. Okay. And similar way, please, whatever be the classes, even though today you have in the afternoon session also, you have one more class. And even though from morning to evening, please do attend all the classes without fail. Okay. And so that unless and until you listen to the classes, you will not be feeling the subject as easier. Okay. So that's what my request and suggestion for you, so that you can feel the subject very easy. Now I am just moving on to the actual subject. Okay, can you able to see the screen as microwave engineering?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. And any doubt, if you want to ask any doubt, let me know if you have any doubt regarding this particular subject. I have not at all started. So meanwhile, I'll be asking the questions from the rule numbers which has been provided, so that I can know to what extent you are able to follow this particular subject, and we'll check out. Okay. And now let me start. Tell me. Okay. Let me start with the first unit, that is the microwave engineering. So microwave engineering is nothing but all the analysis, it is being done at microwave frequency range. And let me explain what is this microwave frequency range, where this particular microwave frequency range, where the communication takes place at microwaves. So that is how it is being called as microwave engineering. The communication, we know that rule number 49, are you there? 49.
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me what is the communication actually? This small definition regarding that communication.
Communication. Talking, giving information to.
Giving information.
Still communicating in something. Communicating something.
The communication itself, I want. Tell me, it's enough normal words in your own way. What is communication?
Talking to someone.
Talking to someone means you are sharing the information from one to other place. So that's what it can be explained. Andy. Fine. Okay. So where the communication, it has been well known that the transmission of the signals are transmission of or the sharing of information from one place to other place. That is from source to destination. And that is nothing but the communication. In the case of antennas, you might be known that the antennas play in a vital role in the field of communications. Well, the signals can be transmitted from source to destination. Even for the long distance communications also, we are making use of antennas, and that is for wireless communications. And where the few cases where we have the communication may not be possible to a larger distances, in order to cover a larger distances, or in order to cover a more amount of information. If we have a large information, it cannot be covered by using a single antenna or smaller frequencies. So that smaller frequencies will have a smaller content. So if you want to share huge amount of data at simultaneously towards a longer distance or larger distance, then we have an option that it should be working at higher frequencies. The frequencies which is being operated to carry higher amount of data should be having a very large frequencies, and the larger distances can be covered, and a larger frequencies will have more content to transmit, so that will go at higher frequencies. So this is the reason why we are going for higher frequencies, and those higher frequencies are nothing but the microwave frequencies. And in this case, we are all discussing that in this total, this particular subject, we are making use of these microwave frequencies. And for that, we have a basic range, the standard range of microwaves, that is 1 gigahertz to 300 gigahertz. So this is the microwave frequency range. And giga, it has been known to you that it is 10 to the power of 9 hertz. 1 giga is equal to 10 to the power of 9 hertz. So this is the microwave frequencies. In textbook, in few textbooks, they have also given as 1000 gigahertz. But most of the standard textbooks, it is being preferred as, it is being considered from 1 to 300 gigahertz. So that is the range, and it can also be represented in terms of wavelengths. That is, in terms of lambda also, we can represent the range of microwaves, and that is being given as lambda is equal to 30 centimeters to 1 centimeter. The lambda value ranging from 30 centimeters to 1 centimeters are comes under the category of microwave wavelengths. So please do remember in these two cases, in terms of frequencies and in terms of wavelengths as well. So that's what I told you. You can write it as in a running notes. So these are the two ways we can represent the microwave frequencies. Now, coming to the second case, that is the second wave as the frequency spectrum and bands. Let me explain what is this frequency spectrum. And we have some standard way to write this frequency spectrum. You might be come across these frequency representations in previous classes and last semester, some antennas you might have discussed, but we have some scenario to represent this frequency spectrum. And let me explain what are these frequency spectrum, how the what is the scenario it is being there to write or represent, and easy way to remember this, so that it is been easily written that. Okay, so for that, you can see here the first frequency range, it is from 3 to 30 hertz, and you can write, you can see from here to here approximately. So whatever the flower bracket have drawn over there, so that indicates that the frequency is being written, and that is being taken, and it is the range of 3 to 30 hertz, and from 30 to 300 hertz, and 300 to 3000. You can see that it is being decayed. It is being varied in terms of decayed, and in terms of 10, it is being written there. And so from here to here, you can see here, up to this particular point, up to this particular point, the same way it has been represented, and accordingly it can be written over there. Each and every frequency range, it has been prescribed, it has been given by some standard frequency designation, that has been called as band. So band designation has been given. So this band is nothing but super low frequency, SLF. And it is been extreme low frequency. So accordingly, each and every frequency, it is been represented by this particular bands. Please, you can have a screenshot, or you can note it down, or you can take a screenshot and you can write it down later on, so that you can have a practice and to write this particular frequencies and their band designations. And these designations are very much important, and it will be asked in the competitive exams also. It has been so many times it has been asked, what is the frequency range of so and so band, and all these similarly it has been worked out. Ultra low frequency, very high frequency, low frequency, medium frequency, high frequency, very high frequency and ultra high frequency. And after that, it is been represented in terms of bands. So the L band, so it is called an L band. It has been taken from 1 to 2 gigahertz here. And the above of this 300 to 1 gigahertz, it is been regulated as ultra high frequencies. And after that, in terms of bands, so 2 to 4 gigahertz S band, 4 to 8 is a C band, and 8 to 12 is the X band. And you can notice that I have drawn some a black mark here. So it has been very important. You should remember this particular frequency range. They'll be asking in Y band, where it is an X band frequencies. So X band frequency, it is ranging from 8 to 12 gigahertz. So this 8 to 12 gigahertz, where we'll be making use for laboratory purpose. The main applications of this particular band is for laboratory purpose. And with this laboratory purpose, where you are going to perform the experiment, as I have told initially, where in that laboratory, the frequency measurement, impedance measurement, whatever we are going to perform, so there we'll be making use of this particular band, 8 to 12 gigahertz. We have a source there, that is reflex klystron is the source, which generates such a high frequency signals. Okay, so please do remember this particular frequency band. Then later on, we have a Ku band, K band and Ka band. After that, millimeter and submillimeter. I'll be showing it. So millimeter and submillimeter frequency bands. So this is the entire thing that shows the particular frequency bands, how it has been written. So once you write twice or thrice, we can easily able to write this bands, and simultaneously you can work with a band designation also. It's been very easy. Please have a practice to write this band designations, so that it will be you can easily understand this. If that class is being disconnected, you can join with the same link once again, so that I can continue there. Okay, and now you can see that, so it is being millimeter band and submillimeter band, so that is going greater than 300 gigahertz. It is being specified as submillimeter band. So this is all about the frequency bands. And apart from that, we have some applications. The applications, why we are using these high frequencies, what are the applications, where do we prefer? Let me explain here. For broadcasting, as I've told that, for broadcasting of the frequencies, where you might be noticing that in a parabolic dish antenna, you might have well known about parabolic dish antenna, you might have seen there. And in the case of dish antenna for broadcasting, all the channels, different channels, some thousands of channels we have, each and every channel will work out with one frequency. So whenever we take a remote and press a particular channel number, that respective program will be playing on the in the TV. So in order to play that, the antennas should able to absorb all the frequencies. So that microwave dish antennas, you might have seen that there are several, around 4 to 5 microwave dish antennas is being used there at a dish, wherever it is being available, the office. And each and every antenna which is being faced at different positions, the angles of facing those antennas will be at different locations, so that it can able to absorb all the signals which is being broadcasted, their frequencies, so that we can able to see all the channels. Okay, so that is how, for those broadcasting of the channels, we'll be preferring the high frequencies. Next, we have a communication. For small communications also, we'll be making use of this particular microwave of frequencies. And for navigation of at the radar navigations, for radar communications also, we'll be preferring these microwave frequencies. And after that, microwave heating. So in order to heat some tubes, we have a big drums, something like that, in order to heat a very high substances where it cannot be melt, it cannot be melted at lower temperature, then we will be going for microwave heating, where it produces very high temperatures in order to melt the respective materials. So there we'll be preferring this microwave heating. And the moisture measurement, it is also one of the important application, where in the atmosphere, normal atmosphere, we have a moisture content. So what is the amount of moisture content which is present in the atmosphere can be measured using these frequencies, so that it is also preferred for moisture measurement. Next, we have the domestic and industrial applications. And you have seen that in the case of domestic, the microwave oven, you are well known about the microwave oven, where we'll be preferring that microwave frequencies in order to heat the food, whatever it has been placed inside it, within just 10 to 15 seconds or 20 seconds accordingly. Using that, we can heat or we can increase the temperature of that particular food which is being placed over there. And that is for domestic applications. And next, coming to the industrial applications. And this industrial applications, in order to maintain a temperature, so a few chemicals or whatever the things, but industries which require some temperatures, in order to maintain the standard temperatures in the industries, we'll be preferring this at those particular instance. And we have a medical applications. So we have some alpha rays, gamma rays, ultraviolet rays. So accordingly, in order to give some treatment to respective patients, so these particular frequencies can be used as for medical applications. And next, we have it is become a powerful experimental tool. So where, as I have told that, in order to know some properties of a material, so whatever the material it has been there, to know the properties of that material, how it has been there, what is the hardest, what hardness it has been there, and how, what are the things it has been involved in that material, to know all those properties, so we can make use of these microwave frequencies. Next, it is also used to know the concentration of different gases. So what are the gas content it has been there, what is the mix-up ratio it has been there. So we can also make use of these microwave frequencies for such applications. And we have, it is also given that for drying the machines. So for printing and in the textile industries, so we'll be making use of these frequencies. So these are all very important applications. So it has been asked in, you can see that around for 2 to 3 marks or 1 mark question, 2 marks question or 3 marks questions, the applications and advantages, it has been asked several times. Okay, please have a glance on this particular applications so that you can easily remember around 4 to 5 applications, so that you can easily write in an examination, internal and external as well. Okay, so this is all about the applications of microwave frequencies. Then we'll be moving on to the advantages and the disadvantages. We'll see these advantages. Now, coming to the point of advantages, where this advantages, it has been listed out there. So it has been having a high frequencies, as these are having very high frequencies, it will be the bandwidth also very high. As the bandwidth being very high, so in order to, if you want to transmit any information which has huge data, then it makes use of such the larger bandwidth. And it can be easily transmitted. The huge data can be transmitted from one place to another place using such frequencies, because as frequencies are very high, then the bandwidth also will be very high. So which can able to accommodate a huge amount of data in it, and simultaneously it can be able to transmit that data. And that the importance of having wide bandwidth. Then we have, as the we are using at very high frequencies, the sizes, the frequency is inversely proportional to the physical length of the apparatus. It is the length of the apparatus is being inversely proportional to the frequencies. As the frequency has been increasing, the size of the physical size of the apparatus used to operate at high frequencies will be less, so that the size of the components will be very less. We'll see these size microwave components in the laboratory. We'll be showing this while doing the experiment. We have a recorded videos which we have done the lab experiment, and we'll be playing it during the lab session. And the second unit, we have a theory part of microwave components. There we'll be discussing in detail regarding this component size, as the size will be of very much less. Then we have the availability, as the it has it can there is no clumsiness of these frequencies, because it is occupying in a huge wide range of frequencies, so that there is no chance of the crowding or insertion of this particular frequencies. The larger space is been enough provided for these frequencies, and the bandwidth will be very high. So it's an important advantage of this particular frequency range. Then, as it has very high frequencies, the resolution of these particular frequencies also will be high. Okay. Next, as I have told the previously, that it has been wider bandwidth, so that the crowding will be less, so that the interference of these particular frequencies will not be there. So it has been having very less chances of interfering those frequencies. So that as there is no interference, then all the information whatever it has been transmitted, that can be easily, it can be able to receive at the destination without any interference or disturbance or noises. Okay, so we have in clarity of that information. Next, it is also having the speed will be very high. Who is that, Andy? Any problem? P3, Manoj, are you there? P3.